One mic. These simple things can be practiced. Let this practice begin from your own home. Practice the mindfulness, presence, bringing your awareness to the breath. And just be mindful when you are sitting with somebody. What you can offer to them as a gift is your presence. Presence is such a valuable gift. We are hardly present. When we are speaking to somebody else, we are present somewhere else. Our mind is somewhere else. It's not a gift that you are offering to the other person. What you can give to them is your presence. Fully be present there, 100%. They feel valued. And a beautiful point Sirisha shared, like, ekku maatladadante first ekku vinali. Listen to everything, everything. Listen to the universe, listen to what nature is speaking, listen to everyone. You will learn more. Then speak from your silence. These things can be practiced from our own home. So friends, in this kind of just a group energy, we have seen, just like an example, you know, you're all strangers, but how much when you started looking deeply, you started connecting. You connect when you look deeply, beyond the judgments, beyond the suffering. There's a compassionate nature in everyone. That's what we need to learn to look at. The Buddha that is present in everyone. The essence which is the soul that is present in everyone. That's where real, when you can look into the people and see the soul energy, that Buddha, that wisdom, then really there is equality. Then you find you are not superior, neither you are inferior, you are all the same. Because inequality is actually nature's anti-principle. It's like an anti-universe principle. Is going against the nature, inequality. In the appearances, it appears to be unequal, but in the soul, there's only equality. High and lows are only judgments with our minds, that I am very high and you are low. And it's so important that we break down this. There is so much equality when you can actually deal with everyone as a soul. When you can learn to look deeply into them as a soul, then suddenly something shifts in us, the deep compassion, even towards your enemy. You will include your enemy into your heart. You will not exclude any person in life. Because everyone is suffering. When the people are suffering, they become angry. Why you are not helping me? Why you are not speaking to me? Why you rejected me? Why all these things? It will make you angry when people are suffering. So everyone is the same in the suffering, you know. They become angry, they throw that anger on others. When you can look deeply, your anger disappears. It transforms into peace. What you can offer to people is that peace through your presence, which comes from your presence. So friends, take another example of being in a chorus. All of you are singing together. Raghupati Raghava Raja Ram. So in that, everyone will sync. You know, if there is no syncing, synchronization, what happens? There is no symphony there. There is no synergy there. There is no orchestration there. Even the Sangha, in the same way, we need to follow. There's a beautiful orchestration, symphony that happens. Everyone has a very unique role to play in the Sangha. Everyone is valued, respected as they are. Everyone is a soul. So everyone actually must be included. And if you look deeply, you'll really understand so many things, many things about the Sangha and Sangha members. So start with your own home. Sometimes we hardly find time. We don't sit quietly. So better to create that space where you all sit. Best time is dinner table. There's one book which is called Kitchen Table Wisdom. Wisdom from kitchen table, dinner table, right? All of you gather at the dinner table, you share the meal. That's the place where you have presence and you offer each other your insights, wisdom, and there you can look deeply into the eyes, you can speak compassionate speech. All this can be practiced. So friends, today we will end with this, and it's so wonderful to meet all of you today, and we will meet again next week. Okay, thank you, and let us give all ourselves clap and all the Sangha clap.
That's beautiful.
So, I want anything to be shared, Ratsekar or Sridevi or the Sangha member Ratsekar? Yeah.
Thank you all for coming for this meditation class. It is one of the most important topics this time, because we all need to understand how to live in this, when we are creating what is called this new enlightened society, with the world is moving towards as we enter this new age. We need to have so much of clarity, because we are not individual beings, as Dr. Hittner has told time and again. Individual evolution is only just one small aspect of our total evolution, and finally when we have to evolve, we have to evolve as a group, and the group energy means that we need to know how to deal with each other, interact with each other, and how to use the collective energy of the whole universe to help in our own individual evolution, and also use our own unique abilities to help others to take everything forward. So thanks for coming here, and we have a lot of these classes every Sunday. Regularly meditation classes are being conducted, and some new interesting topic would be covered, and we want you to spread this word around that meditation classes are taking place here, and a lot of interaction, and the Sadhyan Sanghacha, which is the most important, one of the most important aspects of spiritual growth, is taking place, because you can get to meet with and interact with like-minded people, where instead of wasting time on activities which don't benefit you in any significant way, at least you can come here and interact with people who are having the same pursuits in life, and then it helps you to evolve, and it's not that you're only receiving, you're giving to others, and you're giving when by coming here you're actually doing a great service to everyone. You're not coming here only to just hear someone's lecture or listen, because when you come, you add value to the whole thing. Just as individuals, we all have come into this universe, not because we are some weaklings who have come here to be at the mercy of the whole forces of the universe, but we are come here as powerful creators to add our own creative abilities and power into this universe and contribute to making this universe something which it was not before. So that's how the whole universe evolves, and that's how we all evolve in the process. And so please stay connected. We have our magazines, our publications. Please go through it, because reading is another very important aspect. We have to continuously keep stressing this, the individual dhyana, the meditation, reading of the right kind of books, spiritual for your spiritual growth, and meeting and interaction, the kind of platform that we provide here for everyone to come and meet and interact, for which our entire team is here, and now we have a very wonderful expanded team, the Soul Coach team, who are attending the Soul Coach. They are doing so much of service by going into the society, going into the villages, teaching, creating different teams for different activities like meditation, spiritual science, even things like cleanliness, women empowerment, and even creating abundance, and how to help them to in spiritual agriculture, how to apply spiritual principles for agriculture. So we're doing a lot of initiatives which probably many of you are not aware of. The more you interact with us, the more you interact with our team, you get to know more about the work that we are doing. Go through our websites, read our publications, and interact in whichever way you feel. You will definitely find something that resonates with what you want to do. And you put your energy behind that and support the cause with that particular aspect which resonates with what you want to do. And everyone will find something which is resonating with what they want to do. And I think that will really help to take this whole movement forward and to build a more enlightened society. And that's what I really feel very happy, that seeing so many people. You're not here for without any reason. I mean, there's a specific reason why you chose to be at this point of time, in this space, in this hall, hearing this wonderful lecture, which I probably feel is one of the best that I've ever heard in this whole process. And I really feel that you're all here for a reason, and let it not end here. This is just the beginning. Thank you, friends.
Also,